Hello friends, in this video let's talk about how to restore adventureWorks in SQL 2019. First of all, from where I need to download the adventureWorks and why I need adventureWorks, we need to know. See, adventureWorks is a default database used to provide by the Microsoft. When I say default, it is readily available in Microsoft website. By default, it won't come once you do a SQL Server installation. With this adventureWorks, you can cover as many scenarios as you can in SQL Server learning. There are three adventureWorks sample databases we have in Microsoft website now. The first one is OLTP AdventureWorks. It is nothing but a transactional database. And second one is AdventureWorks Data Warehouse. So if you want to practice data warehousing concepts, then you can use that warehouse for your practice. Or if you want to practice SQL Server analysis services, then you can use that. Then one more is AdventureWorks Lightweight. See, if your system is not capable of holding a big database like AdventureWorks OLTP, then you can download that and you can practice. But it also covers more scenarios. Once you go to the Google, if you Google for AdventureWorks database, it directly show you this Microsoft link. Once you click on that link, you will get this page. You will get this page, AdventureWorks sample databases. See, if you see here, you can see like three versions here, download backup files. So OLTP data is for most typical online transactional processing workloads. Next one is data warehouse. So data is for data warehousing workloads. Next, lightweight data is lightweight and pared down version of OLTP sample. So now you can see here, there are three versions of backups we have. One is OLTP, the name you can see, AdventureWorks 2019.back, data warehouse, AdventureWorks DW 2019.back. So AdventureWorks LT 2019 back. You can see here. And also, not only these three copies of AdventureWorks, you can see them previous version 2017, 2016, and 2016 extension, 2014, 2012, 2008, or 2. You have that. See, like whatever the version is compatible to your machine, you can download that version and you can restore it. Once you click on it, it automatically downloads and it takes a while based on your speed of internet. Okay, so I just downloaded three versions of three copies of AdventureWorks. One is this is the OLTP AdventureWorks 2019. This one is DW 2019. This one is lightweight 2019. Okay, now I'll show you how to do the restore of this AdventureWorks in a SQL machine. So let's quickly click on SSMS. Okay, so if you already know it, that's fine. Otherwise, let's click on SSMS. You'll get this window. Okay, select the database engine and server name as the computer name, or if you have any other specific instance, you can type that. Click on connect. So once you click on connect it, you will see this window. Okay, see, I want to restore existing backup file on my server. Okay, I'm not taking a backup from my server. Okay, so the backup is readily available in the drive. You copy that backup file into an accessible location, okay, where you can access from SQL Server. You need to copy that. Okay, so once it is copied, it's readily available in F drive examples folder. Okay, under that, once the backup file is readily available, okay, you just open SSMS and simply right click on databases and click on restore database. Okay, if you have a LDF, MDF, then you need to go for attach. But I have a backup file, I can go for a restore, and it is easiest option in this scenario. Okay, so let's click on restore database. So once you click on restore database, so you get an option like this, no backup set selected to be restored. That's fine. So that is a default option, you default error, you will get it. So nothing to worry. Okay, now here. So where is your database? My database is in the device. Let's not, by default database is selected here. Let's not select that. Let's select the device. So once you select the device, so you'll get relevant options actually. So one, select the device and click on these three dots option if you see here. Let's click on that. So once you click on it, so you open a kind of pop-up and asking for where is your file, where is your backup media file. So here it, you have like a file or URL, okay? So ideally I have a file only, so select the file and click on add. Once you click on add, it asks for the location. Where is the location? By default, it shows C drive. Why it is C drive means the place where you install the software and the place where you set up the backup and restore paths, by default it shows. Okay, you want to go to this directory, right? Select this and click on paste here and click on enter here. So once you click on enter here, it shows you the list of available files here, backup files. So here on, it shows the backup files only. Even though if I have any other files, it won't come here because backup files and TRN and log files only it will come by default. And like now I want to restore AdventureWorks. Okay, so let's select AdventureWorks 2019.back. So my system is capable of having OLTP full backup. I don't need to go for lightweight. I can go for AdventureWorks 2019 back. Okay, which is having more data. Even the backup file size itself is a 212 MB. Okay, so once you restore it, the size of the database grows actually. I'll show you like how much size once it is restoration is done. Select this AdventureWorks and click on OK. So once you click on OK, you'll get like this path. Okay, click on select this again and click on OK. So once you click on OK, again you lost that error message if you see here. Okay. Error message is gone, and if you see here, it's showing like the all multiple like a checkpoint LSN and all, okay, and the start date and finish date and all, okay. So let's select this. So once you select all this option in this tab, let's go to the files tab. So in this files tab, by default this file will go and sit into this particular location. So ideally in the real time you may need to change the locations, but since it's my practice machine, I can go with the default suggested locations actually. So if still there is an option to change the locations here, original file is this, and where you want to restore, and not only in C drive, you can restore in D drive, H drive, whatever the drive you want. Okay, so that you can do it. Now let's come to the options. So here this tab actually, so if you are restoring on the top of existing database, then you need to select this option, override the existing database. So if you are restoring freshly with AdventureWorks, means I don't have AdventureWorks database previously in my machine. So that time I don't need to select this option. Okay, why? Because the name, I'm going with the same name actually. Okay, so that is the reason I'm not going to touch this. And you can even preserve replication settings and all, nothing to worry because it's a new database. Okay, since it is a new database, I'm not going to select anything here, and I can go with as it is suggested locations. I'm not changing anything here, and general tab is as I already did the changes whatever required. So once you're okay, let's click on okay. So once you click on okay, based on the size of the database, it takes a while. Okay, in my case, since AdventureWorks might be a little small database only, that is the reason why it completed very quickly. So, but in the real time, you need to restore some 200-300 GB of backup file. So once you restore 200-300 GB of backup file, it expands into 2-3 TB of original file. So let's click on OK. So once you click on, see, you can see here, database AdventureWorks 2019 restored successfully. Yes, good. Once you click on OK, so again, that window will be closed, and let's restart it and expand this. Okay, refresh or restart, anything is fine. So this is the database where I did that. Now what is the size of the database is, I can simply right click and go to properties, and I can see, come to the files, I can see here. See here, 264 GB of currently the size of the file, and 72 GB by default size it is coming actually. And you can see the auto growth also. So it is unlimited, data file is unlimited, and a log file is limited to some GB, okay. And you can see in the options like here by default is 2017 is selected compatibility level, but I'm not okay with 2017. I will go with the 2019 only because my version is 2019. So here this is the place where you can check the compatibility level of the database. Since you are in 2019, better to select the 2019 here. Okay. So once you select that option, you need to click on OK. So now what are all the new features of 2019 you can use on the top of this database? See, I'm getting a question like even though I'm using recent version of SQL Server, when I use a keyword of recent version, it is not working. Why? Because the compatibility levels are not set up to the recent version. Okay, so that is a one reason of recent features are not working. Okay, I showed you that. So that's how you do restore AdventureWorks in SQL Server 2019. So I already did the restore for AdventureWorks warehouse earlier for some reasons, but I showed you AdventureWorks 2019. But the process is same. Even if you want to do the lightweight AdventureWorks, also the same process, and it finishes very quickly because it's only 8 MB of size. So that's all about how to do the AdventureWorks restore and SQL 2019. But the process is same in any version of SQL Server, maybe 14, 17 or 16. So that's all about it. Thank you for watching.